Welcome to I Believe TV, the show that takes mystery out of the effects and techniques the media and government use to keep you in the dark. My name is Justin Ballot, and today I'm going to be speaking to you about haters and the religion of the elite. Now, a lot of people have asked me, with all of the hate mail that goes around and all of the accusations that people make against me, whether it bothers me or not. And to be honest with you, of course it doesn't bother me. And I'll tell you why. You see, they did the studies a long, long time ago where they worked out that 20% of the population, it doesn't matter what you say, they automatically believe it. If they say that I'm a liar, if they say that the stuff that I'm selling is junk, if they say that the defense that I use, the human rights defense and the report are a joke, well then these people are automatically going to believe it. There's always going to be 20%. On the other hand, you have 20% of the population that has the intelligence to think and reason for themselves. And straight away, they're going to say, wait a minute. Here you've got a guy who's coming out with his name. It's a 14-year trackable history of being in the marijuana movement, of trying to change the laws. By independent sources, you've got a person who's saying, this is what I do. You can follow me if you want. He's not the leader. He's not saying, I'm the leader, you must follow me. He's just saying, this is what I do, and you can do the same thing as well. A person who's done things that nobody else could do. They've opened up coffee shops, they've opened up seed banks, they've held cannabis cups, etc., etc. You've got the government and the police saying that they would not do anything about this person. These people are going to start to use their own brains and realize that, well, here you've got an anonymous avatar, somebody who hides away behind an anonymous name. You don't know who they are. They're basically what's referred to as keyboard cowboys. They hide away and they make all these accusations. Yet, they never refute the facts, they never ever present any facts of their own, they just keep making accusations. And then in the middle you've got the 60%. Now these 60%, they are the skeptics. They don't know which way to go. So initially they must take the safest option, which is they side with the haters. They go, oh, well, obviously, you know, the guy must be lying. They don't go along and look for themselves initially at, you know, for example, you can go into the Constitutional Court's webpage and you'll see my name is on the Constitutional Court's webpage, case number CCT02/10. If you go and have a look at the cases that were run during 2010, you'll see my name. It's my actual name. It's not something that I'm making up. I don't hide behind an avatar. I actually do this. And slowly but surely, what they found in terms of the studies was that 60%, eventually, they realized that on the one side, you're going to get the haters. And all you're ever going to get from them is the negativity, the complaints, the accusations, with nothing to back it up. On the other side, you've got someone who's fighting for the truth and trying to change the laws and doing it themselves. They actually live the way. They don't hide behind anything. They live this way. And it's all out there. It's all trackable, and it's from various sources. And eventually, over time, what happens is the people that can't make up their minds, the 60% in the middle, they will eventually be introduced. Someone will say, hey, look, I bought this bud from this coffee shop. And I say, jeez, look at the quality there. I heard that it was junk weed. I heard that the guy was just selling junk seeds and junk weed. And this is what the quality was. And it was full of spider mites. 20,000 spider mites were just all over. There's no weed. It was just pure spider mites. Or whatever it is that they want to say. When you have people starting to use the report in court in South Africa and winning, when the cases are being dropped against them, it doesn't take much for that 60% to realize that the haters are exactly that. They're just haters, they're liars, and their agenda is to attack somebody on an ad hominem basis, which means you attack the person, not what they're saying or the facts that they stand for. And eventually that 60% comes over to the side of truth and always works like that. So for me, I don't worry about it because I know the end result. The end result is that there's going to be 20% of haters and there's going to be 80% of the population who understand the way forward. Also, you have to understand that my job is not to deal with haters. I'm not here to, when somebody says, oh, he's a liar, then I'm going to say, no, I'm not. And then they're going to say, oh, he's a liar. No, I'm not. Oh, he's a liar. Oh, no, I'm not. That's not my job. My job is to fight with the government. That's who I fight against. I fight against those people who are in authority, those people who are in power. You've got to understand that the elites of this world have a religion which is called a Freemasonry. They're all Freemasons. And Freemason is the most strict religion out there. And they have very, very strict rules. And their religion is based on Darwinism. It's based on survival of the fittest. And if you go back and have a look at King Solomon, for example, the slaves would approach King Solomon. Whenever they did, The head would be down. They'd be very, very quiet. And it says, "So sorry, King Solomon. So sorry, can I ask you a question, please, King Solomon?" And you can see the same thing happening today. If you go and look, if just go and do a YouTube search on Ask Obama, and look at how the people ask Obama their questions. They don't come out and be direct. They say, "Oh, thank you for your time, sir. Please can I ask you a question, sir? Thank you for being so gracious to allow us to ask the question, sir." And according to the beliefs of the elite, of the most powerful people in the world, they despise the weak. They despise them to the point of complete hatred. They have a hatred for the weak. So whenever somebody hides behind a keyboard, whenever somebody is anonymous, whenever somebody is a keyboard cowboy, and they're hiding away, the elite of this world, those people who actually make the laws and who have the ability to change laws, the haters don't make the laws and they have no ability at all to change laws. These people are weak. And so according to the religions, as I said, the King Solomon, he would keep kicking these people down the stairs, these slaves that would come and ask him for better living conditions and increased wages. And the slave would never ever get upset. They would fall down the steps, they would hurt their arms, they'd hurt their legs, they'd hurt their heads, and they'd just come and say, "Sorry, King Solomon, sorry about that, sorry. It was my fault." And King Solomon eventually said, "Just kill them." And the same thing happened in ancient Rome, where if somebody fought very, very hard and very, very well, and they put in all their heart into the fight, and they fought like a real man, they weren't a coward, they didn't hide away, they fought for their lives. At the end of the day, the king, whoever it was, Caesar, they would come along and they would say, "Let that slave go free," because that slave had deserved, that slave had earned the right to go free. And that's the religion of these people. They believe in survival of the fittest. They do not believe in weakness. They do not believe in somebody hiding away and sniveling and insulting people from a web page where they can be anonymous, where they can be invisible. At the end of the day, the elite will only ever respect that which is of an equal to them. They only respect those people who stand up, who have the balls, who have the courage to stand up for their beliefs. And so that's who I'm dealing with. That's the people that I'm dealing with. I'm dealing with the government. I'm dealing with the elite. I'm dealing with those who are in power. I don't care about the haters. They mean nothing to me. At the end of the day, I know the outcome of what happens with the haters because they've done the experiments time and time again. But in terms of the way it works out, one day, if I get arrested, I've got my defense. I'm willing to fight. I know what to say. I know what to do. I don't have to worry. You have to make your decisions. You can go down the path of the hater. You can follow that path and you can moan and cry and whine and bitch like a baby. But at the end of the day, when you stand up there in court, that court's not going to look at you as if you're a hero. They're not going to say, "Oh, what a hero this guy is. He's put in a fight. He's been brave." No. Under their religion, they hate the weak. The meek shall inherit the earth, 6 feet of earth. That's their religion. That's their belief system. And that's what eventually happens. So for me, I'm going up to the top of the mountain. I can't be worried about what a hater is claiming. Because at the end of the day, there's more than enough people, and there's more than enough documentation, there's more than enough facts, there's more than enough history in terms of what I've done and who I am for me to be able to stand up and say, I don't care what the haters say. Haters can say whatever they like. At the end of the day, I'm going to the top of the mountain. And if you want to go to the top of the mountain, you can choose. You can stay with the haters at the bottom, or you can follow me. I'm not your leader. I'm not your leader. I never claim to be your leader. I just show you the way I do it. This is how I climb to the top of the mountain. These are the weapons I use when I have to fight. This is the way in which I do it. And I actually go and do it in front of your eyes. I don't stand here and say, "Oh, one day I'm going to do this. Oh, one day we're planning on this." One day, today, right now, as we speak, I'll walk to the top of the mountain. And if you want to follow, that's up to you. You can fall in behind. You can continue the fight. You can continue to push like others in the past, like Jack Hera, or anybody else who you know, these great marijuana activists of the past. They didn't hide away. They didn't hide behind an avatar. They put their names out there, they said what they stood for, and they lived it, and they believed it, and they went forward with it. And that's what I'm here to do. So I hope you guys can understand, and I hope you guys realize what's actually going on. These people are not hating for a reason. They're hating because I'm being successful, because I'm achieving something that shouldn't be getting put out there. Anyway, it's up to you to make your own decisions. I can't make your decisions for you. I can't do your thinking and reasoning for you. You must decide what you want. You must decide what you want marijuana to be. Because the decision that you make will determine whether marijuana is legal or not, or re-legalized in the case of what I stand for. It's up to you to decide. You follow, and you will follow either to the path of victory, or you'll get led down the garden path. That's the way it works. That's the way it's always worked. And you have to understand the religion of the elite. They do not respect the weak. They only respect the strong. They only respect those who will stand up for themselves.